Hello everyone, this is Meenakshi Dilip Birari, working as an assistant professor in chemistry at Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samaj, Nasik. We know that ammonia, sulfuric acid and nitric acid are some basic chemicals and which are used directly or indirectly as a fertilizers or as a intermediates for the preparation of other chemicals. So ammonia is a basic chemical which is required to produce nitrogen-containing derivatives. It is also used in the manufacture of fertilizers, explosives and pharmaceuticals. So, today I am going to talk about the manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. In previous lecture, we have studied the manufacture of ammonia by Haber process. The main limitation of Haber process is that the yield of ammonia is low, that is about 8%, whereas the yield of ammonia by Bosch-Haber process is about 19%. So, Bosch-Haber process is preferred to Haber process. So, let us see in detail the manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. For both processes, the principle is same. The manufacture of ammonia is based on the principle that nitrogen and hydrogen react in the volume ratio 1:3 under pressure and at optimum temperature in presence of a catalyst. So we should remember these nitrogen and hydrogen, both reactant, react in the volume ratio 1:3 under the pressure and at optimum temperature in presence of a catalyst to manufacture ammonia. So that is the principle involved in Haber process and also in modified Bosch-Haber process. The modified Bosch-Haber process is sometimes also called Bosch-Haber process. In this process, nitrogen is obtained from producer gas and hydrogen is obtained from water gas. Whereas in Haber process, nitrogen is obtained from liquid air and hydrogen is obtained from steam, hydrocarbon or electrolytic process. For both process, nitrogen and hydrogen are reactants for the manufacturing of ammonia. So, what is the reaction involved? So, for the manufacture of ammonia, one volume of nitrogen reacts with 3 volume of hydrogen to give 2 volume of ammonia. So, it is the reaction involved in the manufacture of ammonia. N2 gaseous plus thrice H2 gaseous gives formation of twice NH3. So, here one volume of nitrogen reacts with 3 volume of hydrogen to give 2 volume of ammonia. Let us see the manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. It is carried out in NiVCr steel converter, that is nickel vanadium chromium steel converter, which is about 7 feet in height and 21 inches in diameter and weighs about 3 tons. The reaction is carried out at about 550 degrees Celsius temperature under 300 atmospheric pressure using a catalyst. After the discovery of Haber, Bosch worked out remaining problems to start the production. Bosch designed a steel reactor that is called as a converter which could withstand the high temperature and pressure. He also found out cheaper ways of getting H2 and N2. The source of hydrogen is water gas and the source of nitrogen is producer gas. Whenever water gas and producer gas are used as the sources of H2 and N2 respectively. So this process, it is called as a Haber-Bosch process or modified Bosch-Haber process. So, what are the raw materials used in manufacturing of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. Nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas are the basic raw materials required for synthesis of ammonia. Different methods are used to obtain these gases. First of all, the hydrogen gas, which is one of the raw material or reactant for the manufacturing of ammonia. Hydrogen gas, it is obtained from any one of the following sources. These are from water gas, that is from CO plus H2. Water gas is nothing but CO plus H2. From coke oven gas, from naphtha, and by reacting natural gas with steam, and by electrolysis of water. So one of the reactant, that is hydrogen gas, it is obtained from water gas, from coke oven gas, from naphtha, by reacting natural gas with steam, and by electrolysis of water. Then nitrogen is obtained from the various methods having the different sources. Nitrogen gas is obtained from producer gas, that is CO plus N2. So what is water gas? That is CO plus H2, and producer gas is CO plus N2. And nitrogen gas is also obtained from air. So nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas are the basic raw materials required for synthesis of ammonia. Hydrogen gas, it is obtained from water gas, from coke oven gas, from naphtha, by reacting natural gas with steam, and by electrolysis of water. Whereas nitrogen gas, it is obtained from any one of the following source, like from producer gas and from air. What is water gas? We should remember that is CO plus H2, and producer gas is CO plus N2. So water gas is obtained from coke and steam. So what is coke? That is carbon, C, plus steam, that is H2O, gives the formation of water gas, that is CO plus H2. So the temperature will maintain 1000 degrees Celsius to 1400 degrees Celsius. In modified Bosch-Haber process, hydrogen gas and nitrogen gas are obtained from water gas and producer gas respectively. So water gas is produced from coke and steam, that is carbon plus H2 give the formation of CO plus H2. Since the reaction is endothermic, the temperature falls rapidly, and water gas produced is cooled and purified by passing through lime and iron oxide. So the reaction is endothermic. Temperature falls rapidly in this reaction. The another reactant, that is nitrogen gas, will be obtained from producer gas. Producer gas is produced from coke and air as coke and air. Air, it contains O2 plus N2. So the mixture of O2 plus N2, twice C plus O2 plus N2, give the formation of twice CO plus N2, that is producer gas. So producer gas is produced from coke and air. Nitrogen of air remains mixed with CO, and the gas is cooled and purified. So the hydrogen gas and nitrogen gas are obtained from water gas and producer gas respectively in modified Bosch-Haber process. So synthetically, ammonia is obtained by the reaction between nitrogen and hydrogen to give the formation of ammonia. One volume of nitrogen reacts with 3 volume of hydrogen to give 2 volume of ammonia. So let us see the process of manufacturing in detail. So it is a flow sheet for manufacture of ammonia by modified Boscobel process. Now we have studied, the water gas is obtained from coke and steam by the reaction with coke, that is twice C plus H2O, to give formation of CO plus H2. So water gas is produced by using such a reaction. The producer gas is obtained from coke and air, that is coke and air reacts to give the formation of producer gas, that is CO plus N2. So we have studied the formation of producer gas and water gas. After that, the reaction occurs in the oxidation tower. So water gas and producer gas are mixed together such that the removal of carbon monoxide and the proportion of N2 and H2 left is 1:3 volume. So 1 volume of nitrogen and 3 volume of hydrogen. It reacts in this oxidation tower. So the mixture of water gas and producer gas is now taken into oxidation tower, where the carbon monoxide is oxidized to carbon dioxide by steam in the presence of iron oxide catalyst, which is promoted by Cr2O3 chromium trioxide at 450 degree Celsius. Then the gaseous mixture coming out of the oxidation tower consisting of the hot nitrogen, hydrogen, carbon dioxide and CO, which are unoxidized, is now cooled by passing through a heat exchanger. The cooled gases are then compressed to 25 atmosphere by passing through the compressor. Further, CO2 is removed by dissolving in water under pressure. Little carbon monoxide, if there, is removed by absorbing in a solution of ammonical cuprous formate, which is kept in a purifier. Then the mixture of pure N2 and H2 in the ratio 1:3 volume, now compressed to 200 to 300 atmosphere and is filtered to remove any oil mixed with it during the compression. So here is the oil filter to remove if there is the presence of oil which is mixed with it during the compression. The reacting gases, that is N2 plus H2, that in the volume 1:3, is now taken in an ammonia converter. The converter is a steel vessel containing finely divided iron catalyst with promoters such as molybdenum or mixture of oxides of aluminium, potassium and calcium. The catalyst temperature is maintained at 500 to 550 degree Celsius. So what is the main reaction which is taking place here? N2 plus thrice H2, which give the formation of twice NH3 plus heat. So it is the main reaction, it occurs in this ammonia converter. In the volume 1:3, 1 volume of nitrogen plus 3 volume of hydrogen to give 2 volume of ammonia. Then this reaction is exothermic, hence once it is started, the desired temperature is maintained by adjusting the speed of entering gases, that is by adjusting the space velocity. The exit gases, about 8%, it contain about 8% ammonia and uncombined N2 and H2 gases. The gases are cooled by passing through heat exchanger. Most of their heat is given to incoming gases in the converter. Then the gaseous ammonia is removed from N2 and H2 by condensation, first with water cooling and then by ammonia refrigeration. at minus 15 degree Celsius. So here is the ammonia refrigerant where the temperature is maintained at minus 15 degree Celsius. So here the N2 and H2 by condensation, first with water cooling and then by ammonia refrigeration at the temperature minus 15 degree Celsius. The unreacted N2 and H2 are recycled. There is again the unreacted N2 and H2 which is remaining, that is recycled to form the ammonia. The liquefied NH3 is collected in a storage tank, that may be spherical storage tank. So the ammonia which is obtained after the cooling, that is at minus 15 degrees Celsius in the liquid form, that is liquefied ammonia collected in the storage tank. So N2 and H2 whenever subjected in ammonia refrigerant at minus 15 degree Celsius, we get the formation of ammonia in liquid form, and that liquid ammonia will be collected in storage tank. So it is the flow sheet for manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. So we have studied in detail the manufacturing of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process with the help of such a type of the flow sheet diagram. Also, this one is the process flow diagram for the manufacturing of ammonia. Here also the water gas and producer gas are used to form the ammonia. Ammonia is obtained in the liquid form. So it is also the flow sheet for manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. So let us see the steps involved in the manufacturing. Already I have explained in detail the whole process of manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. Let us summarize the process involved in manufacturing of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. So a mixture of water and producer gas is passed in an oxidation tower. The carbon monoxide from water gas and producer gas is converted to CO2 by steam using iron oxide catalyst that may be promoted with Cr2O3 and CO2 at 450 degree Celsius. So what is the reaction which occurs in the oxidation tower? So reaction taking place in the oxidation tower, it is CO plus H2O at 450 degree Celsius give the formation of CO2 plus H2. The reaction is exothermic due to the heat produced. The reaction can continue even at low temperature, and hence the temperature is kept 450 degree Celsius. Then the gaseous mixture of CO2, H2, N2 and unreacted CO or unoxidized CO is cooled in a heat exchanger and compressed to 25 atmospheric pressure. The unwanted gases, that is carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide, are removed in a scrubber as follows. So CO2 is removed by dissolving it in water under pressure, that may be CO2 plus H2. It is converted into H2CO3, that is carbonic acid. So the CO2, which is unwanted gas which may be formed, it is removed in a scrubber by using such a type of the reaction. CO2, it is reacted with water. By dissolving it in water, there is the formation of H2CO3. So under the pressure, CO2 is converted to H2CO3 by dissolving it in a water. Then the solution of cuprous formate is boiled with the gaseous mixture to remove carbon monoxide and recycled. So these are the reactions which occur in the oxidation tower. Then the reaction in the converter, the mixture of pure nitrogen and hydrogen in the ratio 1:3 is further compressed to 200 to 300 atmosphere in a compressor and then passed through oil filters to remove oil if there may be presence of oil or the mix with the process during the compression. Now the mixture of gases is passed over finely divided iron catalyst. Also, we can use the molybdenum promoter kept at 500 degrees Celsius in NiVCr steel converter. The catalyst in the granular form is kept in the central portion of the converter. The gases are heated to 500 degrees Celsius and passed through the catalyst. So in the converter, the mixture of pure N2 and H2 in the ratio 1:3 is now compressed to 200 to 300 atmosphere and is filtered to remove any oil mixed with it during the compression. The main reaction taking place in the converter is that N2 plus thrice H2 give the formation of twice NH3. So it is the main reaction which occurs in the converter, N2 gaseous plus thrice H2, that is one volume of nitrogen, three volume of hydrogen to give two volume of ammonia. The reaction is exothermic and can continue even at lower temperature. The required temperature, which is maintained by adjusting the speed of entering gases. That means we have to maintain the space velocity to maintain the temperature. Then the next one, that separation of ammonia from the unconverted gases. So the outgoing mixture of gases contain 8% of ammonia and unconverted N2 and H2. The mixture is cooled first by circulating cold water and then by ammonia refrigeration at minus 15 degrees Celsius. The liquid ammonia is collected in a storage tank. The unconverted gas mixture, that is N2 and H2, is again compressed to 300 atmosphere and then mixed with fresh compressed gas mixture in the compressor and recirculated. So the outgoing mixture or the exit gases contain about 8% of NH3 and uncombined N2 and H2. This mixture, the gases of the mixture, it is cooled first by circulating cold water and then by ammonia refrigeration at minus 15 degrees Celsius. So that liquefied ammonia is collected in a spherical storage tank and the unconverted gas mixture N2 and H2 is compressed to 300 atmosphere and then mixed with fresh compressed gas mixture in the compressor and recirculated. So it is the whole manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. So in this lecture we have studied in detail the manufacture of ammonia by modified Bosch-Haber process. In next lecture we will see the physico-chemical principles involved in the manufacture of ammonia. Thank you.